أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون صدق الله العظيم. I seek refuge with Allah from Satan the rejected. In the name of Allah, who is most gracious, most merciful. Alhamdulillah, once again we thank Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala for sparing our lives and giving us the health and guidance of coming out and offering our Jumu'ah Salah. Praise be to Allah, whose glory and might cannot be screened or hidden. Similarity in properties and characteristics of created things is an evidence that there can be no similarity between him and his creatures, and that he has no equal or partner. And I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, who is true and faithful to his promises. He is eternal, having no beginning or help from his creatures. Minds accept his existence, but not with the help of sight and senses. His creatures bear witness to his being without coming into contact with him. Imagination and comprehension cannot surround him, but can realize his mighty existence. I bear witness that Muhammad, upon whom be peace, is his servant and messenger. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala sent him among mankind to show them the right path, guiding them to differentiate between right and wrong, between truth and falsehood, between vice and virtue, and between piety and sinfulness. He showed them the true way to salvation, illuminated the path of religion, fixing minarets of light all along the way, and strengthening the bonds of Islam and the ties of faith. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala bestow blessings on our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and on his followers forever. Alhamdulillah, my dear brothers and sisters, for today's khutbah I have chosen three simple words: love, fear, and hope. One of the most beautiful things about the concept of worship in Islam is the truly unique way in which it incorporates the feeling of love, fear, and hope within the hearts of the worshippers of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Understanding to combine these three qualities into the worship or ibadah of Allah is one of the most essential things that every Muslim must grasp, not least because every sector which has drifted from the straight path has strayed in the aspect of worship. The deviation of the other religious or religions in this regard is clear for all to see. God is love. Jesus is love, says the Christians. Denying the fact that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala should be feared too. As for the Jews, their hearts were filled only with hope, hope that the fire will never touch them, since they were the promised people. In Islam, however, no worship is complete without the presence of all these three qualities: love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hope in His mercy, and fear of His punishment. Contemplate the opening surah of the Quran, Surah Al-Fatiha, and you will see this for yourselves. In the first ayah, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alami, all praise and all thanks is for Allah, Rabb of all the worlds. In this ayah or verse of the Quran, we have love of Allah, and every time we recite this ayah, we are testifying to our love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is that, you ask? It is because in the ayah we are acknowledging that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Rabb and the Rabb of all the worlds. Rabb is usually translated as the Lord, but this translation does not do justification to this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and all the meanings this name carries. In reality, Rabb means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of everything. He sustains and nourishes everything. He gives life and death. Anything good that we have is from Him. Everything is dependent on Him, and nothing can happen unless He wills it. Furthermore, for the Muslims, He, the Rabb, is the one who has guided us to the truth and given us good morals and manners. Thus, when we testify that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Rabb, then we are acknowledging that He is the one who has given us many blessings. So many that if we try to enumerate His blessings, we would be unable to do so. So how could we not but love Him? After all, we all love those who show kindness towards us. Our presence us with gifts, and therefore the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged the exchange of gifts between Muslims because it helps to strengthen ties and develop love for one another. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Give gifts to one another, you will come to love one another." And this hadith is taken from Sahih al-Bukhari. My dear gathering, so imagine the love we should have for our Rabb, who has given us everything, such as nice families, shelter, security, food, health, and above all, the guidance of Islam and the Sunnah. We should be overwhelming in our love for Him. That is why we praise Him and thank Him and say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise and thanks is for Allah, Rabbil Alameen. And then we go to ayah 2. Ar-Rahman Nir-Rahim. The Rahman, the merciful, and Rahim, mercy given. In the first ayah of the Surah Fatiha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned He was the Rabb. In this ayah, two more of His beautiful names are mentioned, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman means that He is most merciful, and Ar-Rahim means He is the giver of mercy. In other words, His actions are full of mercy, and He shows mercy to his creation. When we mention these two names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we have hope, since he is the one who is full of mercy, and we hope he will forgive our mistakes and shortcomings. We should never lose hope, because Almighty Allah tells us in the Holy Quran, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنُطُوا مِن رَّحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. The meaning of which, O my slaves, who have transgressed against themselves, despair not of the mercy of Allah. Verily, Allah forgives all sins, except sins. Truly, He is all forgiving, the most merciful. And this ayah is taken from Quran chapter 39, ayah 53. The need to have fear in our worship is shown by the next ayah of Surah Fatiha, which is Maliki Yawmiddin, King, Master of the Day of Judgment. When we recite this ayah, we remind ourselves of the Day of Judgment, that awful day when all the humanity shall stand before Almighty Allah, naked, uncircumcised, and barefooted. People will appear drunk, though they are not. On that day, every person will stand before Almighty Allah and account for his sins, knowing that not even the smallest action which he did is hidden from Allah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us again in Al-Quran, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَمَنْ يَعَمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَاهُ وَمَنْ يَعَمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَاهُ. The meaning of which, so whosoever does good equal to the weight of an atom shall see it, and whosoever does evil equal to the weight of an atom shall see it. Chapter 99, ayat 7 and 8. My dear gathering, so when we recite this third ayah of Surah Al-Fatiha, we remind ourselves of this judgment and accountability, and that should bring about in us a sense of fear, that maybe our evil actions will be too great and we will be responsible for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from such a fate. Then the next ayah goes to say, Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. You alone we worship. That is, we single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our worship. And how do we worship Him? With love, fear, and hope. And in order to achieve these qualities, we need Allah's assistance. We seek His aid. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. My dear brothers and sisters, after understanding the need to have love, hope, and fear in our worship, the next question that naturally arises is that, in what proportion should these qualities be present in our worship? Again, we turn to the Quran for the answer. as Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala reminds us, وَدْعُوهُ خَوْفًا وَتَعَمًا وَدْعُوهُ خَوْفًا وَتَمَعًا. Call upon him with fear and hope. Chapter 7, Ayah 56. And again, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala again reminds us, تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِئِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا. Their sides forsake their beds to invoke their Lord in fear and hope. Chapter 32, Ayah 16. So both fear and hope should be present in our hearts in equal proportions. Anas radiallahu anhu reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam entered upon a young boy who was dying. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked, "How are you?" And the boy replied, "O Messenger of Allah, I am between hoping in Allah and fearing for my sins." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The like of these two qualities do not unite in the heart of a servant, except that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala gives him what he hopes for and protects him from what he feared." Again, this hadith from Abu Tirmizi. Therefore, whenever we do good actions, we should hope that it has been accepted by Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. But at the same time, we should also have hope or have fear that maybe it isn't enough, or that the good deed has not been worthy of acceptance. Likewise, when we sin, we should have hope that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will accept our repentance and forgive us. But we should also fear that we may be accountable for it. Thus, this balance should be reflect in our da'wah, which of course is also worship. So when we invite others to the truth, we should not give them the impression that they have nothing to worry about, nor do we suggest that they are doomed forever. Rather, we couple warnings with encouragement. We inform them of the horrors of the fire and tell them about the bliss of paradise. Just as we find Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala telling us in the Holy Quran, "Verily, your Lord is quick in punishment, and verily, He is all forgiving, the giver of mercy. Inna rabbaka lasari'ul iqab wa innahu lagafurur rahim." Chapter 7, Ayah 167. My dear brothers and sisters, the scholars of Islam says, he who worships Allah with hope only is a murji. He who worships him in fear only is a haru'uri. And he who worships Allah in love only is a zindiq. The Christian example, but he who worships Allah in fear, love, and hope is a mu'min, a believer upon tawheed. Unfortunately, all too often nowadays, we find similar attitude amongst many Muslims today, which is why we find that so often we try to advise someone to turn to the deen and abandon sins. They just point to their hearts and say, "Allah knows what is in my heart," or "Allah forgives," or something else like that. As for the Khawarij, they worship Allah in fear only because they held that anyone who commits major sins was a disbeliever and would therefore dwell in hellfire forever. This, of course, is gross extremism and straying from the correct path. Our Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there were two men of Banu Israel who strove equally. One of them committed sins and the other strove hard in worship. And the one who strove in worship see the other in sin and kept saying to him, desist. So one day he found him committing a sin, and so he said to him, desist. So he replied, leave me by my Lord. Have you been sent as a watcher over me? He said, by Allah, Allah will not forgive you, nor will Allah admit you to paradise. Then these souls were taken, and their souls were taken, and they came together before the Lord of the worlds. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to one who strove in worship, did you have knowledge of me, or did you have any power in what is in mine hands? And he said to the sinner, go and enter paradise through my mercy. And he said to the other, take him to the fire. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said, by him in whose hands my soul, he spoke a word which destroys this world and the hereafter for him. Therefore, we should never say to anyone or of anyone that he or she is a lost cause or doom or the like of this is a great sin. However, we fear for those who commit major sins because they have been threatened with punishment in the Quran and the Hadith. However, it is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whether he chooses to punish them or whether he will forgive them, because they, at least, they are his servants. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us what we hope for and protect us from what we fear. And may the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his family, his companions, and upon all those who follow guidance until the last day. Alhamdulillah, my dear brothers and sisters, let us all heed and take warning from these three powerful words. Every day, some of us use these words every day. Love. Every day, we tell our children we love them. When we drop our children to school, the small ones, we kiss them and we tell them we love them. This love we should have, you know, in our heart. And not only for our children and for things and properties, no. Love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Love, and this love, we have to put it into actions. If we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what he commands us to do, then we will do it inshallah. And this is how we could see it and how other people will see it around us. So to the fear comes in our heart when we know the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because his punishment is very severe. In many places of the Quran, there are ayats which states that his punishment is severe. But of course, he is most merciful and he shows mercy. Right? And then we have hope in his mercy. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for our shortcomings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aid us to walk righteousness in this world for the eternal bliss of the hereafter. May he make good for us our religion, whereby we are guided, our present life wherein we live, and our hereafter, whereto is our return. Barakallahu lana wa lakum fil Qur'ani al-azim, wa nafa'ana wa iyyakum bi ayati zikril hakim, innahu ta'ala jawarun karimun malikun barrun. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah nahmadahu wa nasta'inahu wa nastaghfir wa na'udhu billahi wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlilhu fala hadiya lahu wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa nashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasul inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin bi adadi man salla wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin bi adadi man qada wa qam. Wa salli ala jami'il anbiya'i wal mursalin wa ala kulli malaikatil muqarrabin wa ala ibadillahis salihin برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله تعالى أولى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأتم وأهم وأكبر أقيم الصلاة